Good afternoon, students, class 10. Let's move on to the next chapter, space organization in the kitchen. Firstly, before starting the chapter, we should take three points into consideration. Firstly, a kitchen should be airy, well lighted, and properly ventilated. This is the first point. Second is, it should have an eastern or northeastern aspect. It should be in the eastern side of our house or northeastern location of our house. Number three is, it should have three major working areas, that is the cooking area, the refrigerator, and the sink. Three major working centers and properly available storage space. These three things should be considered while planning a kitchen mainly. Okay, now we'll come to the characteristics of kitchen. Characteristics of kitchen is very important. Question often comes from here. What are the characteristics of a kitchen? Mostly the housewives spend most of the time in the kitchen. So it is desirable that the kitchen should be cheerful. It should have a cheerful effect. Well ventilated, well lighted, and have a good sanitary facility. The surface of the counter should be durable, easy to clean, heat resistant, and non-absorbent. These are the points. You have to remember this. The surface of the counter should be heat resistant, as I already said. Cross ventilation is a must, and if possible, there should be a chimney in the kitchen also. The window over the sink helps the housewife to have a good view of the outside landscapes and all. And it's better to have a window just above the sink. General central light can be there, or there can be specific lights also on the work centers as a focusing lights, as we call it. It can also be there. The ceiling color should be white because it will reflect the light and make the kitchen more brighter and spacious. Clear? So these are the characteristics of a good kitchen. Next is the work areas in the kitchen. What are the work areas? Firstly, the storage center, preparation and mixing center, and cooking or stove. So what is a storage center? Refrigerator or dryer, whatever is there in the kitchen, we can store stuffs or the utensils in the storage centers. And preparation or mixing center, over here we can do the dicing, chopping, all the preliminary activities of cooking, that is cleaning, trimming, chopping, dicing, mixing, everything to make the food ready to cook. Okay. Next comes the cooking area or the stove area, where we generally prepare the food. We cook the food over here. The work triangle is defined by the National Kitchen and Bath Association as an imaginary straight line. Work triangle should be there in the kitchen to have proper efficiency of work. So what is it? It is an imaginary straight line drawn from the center of the sink to the center of the cooktop, to the center of the refrigerator, and finally back to the sink. Okay, so it's imaginary line from the center of the sink to the center of the cooktop to the center of the refrigerator and back to the center of the sink. These three major units, basically the refrigerator, sink, and cooking stove, should be ideally in a triangular arrangement so that it will be easy for the housewife to handle the work in the kitchen. Next is the types of kitchen. There are several types of kitchen, but there are two styles. One is the Western style and the other one is the Indian style or the sitting style. Western style further is divided into Pullman or strip kitchen, corridor kitchen, L-shaped, U-shaped, broken U-shaped, and island kitchen. And the sitting type is available mainly in the villages. So what is a foreign Pullman or strip kitchen? It's a one-walled kitchen. There are many rooms or there are many houses where they have very less rooms. So they can use only one wall as a kitchen. It is found in small houses in which there is little space for the kitchen. The strip kitchen is the one which where all the three work areas are adjusted in one single wall. The housewife will have to run from one end to the other end of the wall to do the work. The homemaker moves from one end to the other for food preparation. No work triangle really exists in this kind of arrangement. But it can be made more efficient by planning the sink center between the fridge and the cooking center. If you plan the sink center in between the cooking and the fridge center, it will be more efficient in this kind of kitchen. Next is a corridor type. It is basically a strip kitchen, very similar, but two wall is being used over here. Okay, two walled kitchen. It resembles the strip kitchen, the only difference being that the work counters are on both sides of the wall in front of each other. This is more workable kitchen, but the disadvantage is there is a lot of passage of the people residing in the house from the corridor. So, lot of hindrance in cooking. That is the main problem in meal preparation. Storage and preparation center is on one side and the cooking on the opposite side as usual. Though it forms a very good and efficient work triangle, it has a very good and efficient work triangle, sometimes makes the space appear too narrow since the space problem is there. The distance between the two parallel counters should be approximately 4 feet. The distance between two parallel work counters should be 4 feet. Next is a U-shaped kitchen. It's basically a good type of a kitchen, rather the best type of a kitchen, where in terms of the efficiency of work. Also, it does not become have a hindrance in the meal preparation because there is efficiency of work, and also it does not become the thoroughfare pathway to move from here to there. The three work centers are there on three adjacent wall. On the three adjacent wall, three work counters are there. It provides a great deal of continuous counter space of work, and it's comfortable for more than one person to work in the U-shaped kitchen. Two corners are there for the cabinets, present in manner storage challenge. So, plenty of storage space is there. Next is the L-shaped kitchen. It is also a good type. It leaves two walls empty for windows and doors, and free corner that can be utilized for keeping built-in storage or dining area. It leaves two walls for the doors and the windows, and the other one, free corner, is there for utilization of the built-in storage if you have, or dining area. Three work centers right to left are placed on two adjacent walls. What is a broken U-shape? It provides good continuous space for working. It's similar to the U-shaped kitchen, but the continuity of work is broken in the broken U-shape. One arm of U forms a pass through the counter. Next is the island-shaped kitchen. Essentially, the island layout is an extended version of L-shaped. It is an extended version of L-shaped kitchen or U-shaped kitchen with an additional work area in the middle. It has an additional work area in the middle. It needs a fairly larger room. The top of the island-shaped kitchen can be used to include a hob or a sink, or it can purely serve as an extra work surface, probably acting as a breakfast area. So the middle space can be used as a breakfast area. Most island-shaped kitchen are made on standard height 900 mm and they are 1200x1200 in size. The smallest size of island is however being 600x900 mm. The last one is the Indian or the sitting type. Over here, these are mainly available in the villages. Here, the housewife cooks in a sitting position where there is racks and the almirahs at a low height. However, there should be proper ventilation of smoke from this kitchen. And this type is becoming outdated nowadays because many of the housewives are suffering from leg pain, waist pain, and all these. So these are not so appropriate nowadays. Next, we'll shift to planning and location of work centers.